Hey guys, Theo here, and welcome to the Caffeine Zone, where we discuss everything coffee. And in this instant coffee tasting series, today we will be tasting the Douwe Egberts Espresso-Style, the bold and intense coffee. Normally I don't like this one, because it's slightly too intense for me, but unfortunately we'll have to taste it. So, Douwe Egberts, invented in the 1700s, huge European coffee. And again, being European coffee, they know how much coffee to use because their cups are all the right sizes. Now, they don't say it on the Douwe Egberts or the Jacobs bottles, but we're just gonna go with 2.2 grams, good standard, same as Jacobs. So I will have 4.4 grams for my 200 mils, which is 2.2 grams per 100 mils of water. I'm gonna go full spoon. And it's 4.6. Here we go, 4.4. Love it. In that case, this coffee should last you forever because it's a small cup. Never, ever, ever use boiling water. I can never state this enough. You extract too much bitterness from the coffee and therefore you need sugar. We don't want to use sugar. Okay. Water, 85 degrees Celsius. Ooh, very interesting crema on top. If I remember correctly, the gold had this beautiful gold blanket on top. This one is slightly darker. This is almost more like a brown crema, very similar to espressos. All the way up to 200 mils. Okay, 30 seconds into it. Let's quickly fast forward to 2 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes. Let's give it a good stir. Make sure all of the coffee has dissolved. Now for those of you that have missed previous videos, the way that this freeze-dried instant coffee is made is they literally make the coffee from beans. This is actual coffee beans, guys. They make it into a liquid. They put it into this humongous, very, very cold freezer, or they use liquid nitrogen, and they freeze them instantly. They then break them with steel claws into these little crystal-shaped coffee particles. They then put them into a humidified dried oven. They take out all of the humidity, put it in a little tin and sell it to you as coffee. So it is still coffee. I'm definitely sure that this is Robusta. They don't say it, so therefore I'm just going to stick to it. But if it said Arabica, then we could then obviously go, okay, it's Arabica and Robusta blend. So definitely Robusta, because they don't say anything. Okay, let's taste it. Much, much, much darker than the gold roast. Okay, so first, taste, get the feeling, make sure the tongue has tasted all of the coffee. Definitely on the intense side. Ooh, very heavy on the center of the tongue. First slurp. Wow, that one got me. And always 3 sips before you make up your mind. Wow, definitely nice and heavy on the side, very heavy in the back. Okay, sweetness, acidity, bitterness. Sweetness, very low. I'm gonna say 2 out of 10 sweetness. Not very sweet at all on the tip of the tongue, which means this can definitely do with some milk. I still won't add sugar because there would be enough sugar inside the milk to make up for that. Acidity. I'm gonna go with an 8 out of 10 acidity. It's fairly high, very intense on the side, and very, very heavy to the back of the throat. So bitterness, probably about a 5, maybe even a 6 out of 10. So, not a bad cup of coffee. Definitely need some milk, but no sugar needed. I like it. So if this sounds like a coffee that you would enjoy, then this is the one you go for. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you on the next tasting. May you find your happy place in every single cup.